Hi everyone, in this video we are going to see how to stitch Aari rope or Zardhosi rope. Please subscribe our channel for learning Aari embroidery, and for seeing the advanced stitches please click the name Fashion Trendy below this video and check the playlist for all the basic and advanced stitches. Thank you for subscribing this channel. So first, today I am going to cut the Zardhosi a medium size. So I'm stretching the Zardhosi, and so I'm cut the Zardhosi in the medium size. All the Zardhosi should be in equal size. So please cut in such a manner so all the Zardhosi will be in equal size. So on the measurement, I'm going to use 0.7 centimeter for this Aari rope. You can cut in either way, but make sure all the Zardhosis are in equal size before starting the stitches. So then we can start with the Zardhosi rope. I'm going to draw a straight line. So on the straight line, I'm going to stitch the Zardhosis. So first, starting with the stitch, and then I think you can remember the back stitch which I had taught in already in the basic stitches. It's a one long stitch and then a small stitch, and we have to come back in the middle. We have to make a stitch and then a short stitch. So as this goes, so we have to make first a Zardhosi stitch and a short stitch. So the Zardhosi will be in the same place. So then we have to take the needle back without Zardhosi. We have to punch in the middle of the Zardhosi. You can see I'm pushing the Zardhosi that side and then stitching in the middle, and then a short stitch for keeping the stitch in the place. So this goes like this. We have to make the Zardhosi stitch and then a short stitch, and we have to come back in the middle of the Zardhosi and push the Zardhosi little side, and we have to make the stitches. So after we finishing, you can see it will be in the twisted form. So it's an important stitches in the Aari advanced courses, because we can use it in either in the outline, neck outline, or in the fillings. So we can stitch it anywhere. We can stitch it in any shapes also. The thing is very easy. We have to stitch the Zardhosi from the base, and starting with the Zardhosi, a stitch and a short stitch to keep the Zardhosi in the place, and then coming back to the middle of the stitch. In the middle, we have to push the Zardhosi a little so that the stitches will be in the middle of the cloth. We should not stitch on the Zardhosi, it will be in the cloth. So then we have to make a short stitch. So after that, the stitches we have to finish with the knot. So we can see it is like a twisted rope. So it is called the Aari rope, Aari Zardhosi rope. So you can, it looks very beautiful. And when we are making a leaf design, we usually fill in the middle part with the beads if we are using the double buttonhole stitch. So instead of that, we can use this Zardhosi rope stitch. We can use it in either in the outline or in the middle filling. It's our wish. It's important stitch. So practice this. If you don't know how to stitch in the Zardhosis, no problem. We can stitch with the normal needle and the thread. So I'm taking the zero size needle and then start stitching. So it's as I'm making a stitch with the Zardhosis and then coming back. So then and then I'm going to stitch the other stitch in the middle of the Zardhosi. So that we have to punch only in the cloth, not in the Zardhosis. So it's very simple. When we use this needle and thread, you can use either the Zardhosi needle or the normal needle. So practice with the Zardosi needle so that it will be easy for you to handle, because I know Zardosi may take time for practicing. So from the beginning itself, you can start with the Zardosi needle so that it will be you can finish the work easily and fastly than the normal needle. If you don't know, just you can use this the method also. So at last we have to make a knot. So in this video, but I usually the knot should be on the downside. So for showing you, I'm showing it in the upside. You can see that. But whenever you are going to do, just you can make the knot as I'm doing in the downside. If it's not coming for you, then you follow this method also. So it's very simple. So knot is very important. If you didn't make the knot in the normal hand stitches, the Zardosis will move off, so and everything will be wasted. So after finishing, just practice the knot stitches also. But I'm going to show in the upside just for the video, but usually I'll do it in the downside. So how I'm holding the thread and how I'm going to punching, you can see in this video. So after finishing this, I'm going to show in different shapes. Example, today I'm going to show in the circle shape. We can use this in the mango shape, flowers, even anywhere we can use. I'm going to show in the circle shape. When we're making the stitch in a circle, we have to be very, because the shape should not change. So practice very slowly for the beginners. So you can see how I'm going to. So first you can hold the thread with the left hand. So and then I'm going to punch. So when I'm going to take it from the downside, so the thread and the needle should come between this thread which I have holded in the hands. So as this I'm showing in the upside, we have to make in the downside. So we should not leave the stitches. We have to hold like this and then make the stitches. So then I'm going to make the same stitches in the circle pattern, same way, a long stitch and a short stitch, and coming back and then making a long stitch and a short stitch, and then leaving the Zardosi for the next stitch. So that's it. Practice all the stitches. It's very easy. So it will be very beautiful when we're making it in the blouses. So when we making the stitches in the circle shape, just make the stitches exactly on the circle drawn. The punches should be exactly on the circle. So make sure the shape doesn't change. So that's all. Practice the stitches and use it in your designs. So I'll show you everything in the blouse designs.